Ready for tonight's show, Jacob?
Is it really time already? Roll the intro.
Welcome to MSU Tonight. I'm Alora Gunn.
And I'm Jacob Wiley.
On tonight's show, we'll dive into the bicentennial of Callaway County and what they had in store for this historical landmark. We'll also find out more about what events will be happening this week on campus and around Murray.
Finally, we'll have our very own Dylan Norton reviewing a short film called Grief. It should be a fun with a spicy surprise.
But right now, it's time for Hot Topics. This Saturday, November 5th, the Callaway County Humane Society hosted its Holiday Bazaar, open to the public from 9 to 2, with a variety of items available to browse and purchase for members of your furry family. This fundraiser serves to promote awareness for the Humane Society's important role as an organization in Murray and Callaway County, with all donations earned going directly to Humane Society's many programs and services that provide for the less fortunate animals in our community. The Humane Society is always accepting volunteers and donations, especially during the holiday season.
This is our biggest fundraiser, which we have not been able to have for 2 years now because of COVID. So this was our big comeback year. We get wonderful donations from just people in the community, and we just look to sell as much as possible that we use for all of our programs, everything from spay and neuter, the animal assistance program, the food bank. We are always looking for, in need of fosters for puppies, dogs, cats, kittens. We'll open anybody with big open arms to be volunteers also.
On Friday, November 11th, the annual holiday art auction will be held in the Clara M. Eagle Art Gallery on the 7th floor of Price Doyle Fine Arts. There will be a silent and live auction, and the proceeds will fund scholarships for students in art and design. The event will begin at 4:30 p.m. and end at 9 p.m., with the live auction beginning at 7 p.m.
This week, Waterfield Library is hosting the annual International Games Week. This week-long event is to celebrate friendly competition and to learn about different games around the world. Games Week kicked off Sunday at 3 p.m. with Magic the Gathering. Waterfield will be hosting different gaming events every day this week, including trivia, board games, Smash tournaments, and more. Some events will even be hosted by the Murray State Esports team in chess club. Come out to the Waterfield Library Gallery one night this week for some friendly competition and a good time.
Callaway County turned 200 years old on November 3rd, and MSU Tonight's Ben Overby was in attendance at the ceremony.
People from all over Callaway County gathered in the Rotary Amphitheater in Central Park Thursday for the Founders Day Bicentennial Celebration, hosted by the Callaway County Fiscal Court. The event began with a presentation of colors from the Murray State ROTC and a performance of the national anthem by 1st District Kentucky Supreme Court Justice Shay Nickel.
Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave.
Callaway County Clerk Antonia Faulkner read the minutes for the event and included a brief history of Callaway County.
The County of Callaway was created and its commissioners named. On January 16, 1823, said commissioners met in the town of Wadesboro and effected the first county court for Callaway County.
Local author Bobby Smith Bryant read the poem We Are Callaway County, which presents portraits of both the region and the people who have called it home over its 200 years, including settlers, Civil War soldiers, and freed former slaves.
We are hired hands, fun seekers, and music makers. We learn to work together during hog killings, quilting bees, and barn raisings.
Governor Andy Beshear, Senators Rand Paul and Mitch McConnell, and Representative James Comer all sent speakers to represent them at the event.
Now therefore I, Andy Beshear, Governor of the Commonwealth of Kentucky, do hereby pay tribute to the Callaway County Bicentennial Celebration to honor and highlight the many milestones celebrated throughout the county.
One of the beautiful things about Kentucky is that each county has its own unique identity and a pride attached to its people. Rarely do people identify with their cities. Instead, when asked where they're from, they proudly tell you which county they call home. Callaway County is no different. Those who have been raised in this area of the Purchase proudly identify with Callaway and with all the things that make it so special.
I really enjoyed both of the bands from Murray and Callaway performing. I think they each did a good job representing each school district.
County Judge Executive Kenneth C. Imes closed the ceremony by telling the crowd what Callaway County has meant to him throughout his life.
This is truly my home. And someday, when Mayor Best started messing with me, I'll be laying about 1,500 feet right over there, too. So I keep it all in a very tight circle.
You know, history happens every day, and it gets recorded. But at some points, you just got to sit back and celebrate where you've been. Looking back at history, celebrating it, gives you great perspective on where you're going to go in the future. You can look at the past in a celebration, at the high points, at the low points, and then you can grow on that for future growth in the county.
The ceremony was followed by a free lunch and the release of the Bicentennial Commemorative History Book.
By and by, hard times come a knocking at the door. Then my old Kentucky home, good night.
For all you foodies out there, Taco Bell has recently announced the return of the widely beloved nacho fries. Having started October 13th, the fries will remain on the Taco Bell menu for a limited time only. So be sure to grab yourself some before supplies run out. After an extremely successful test in California last year, the world begged Taco Bell to bless the rest of us with the loaded nacho fries. Fortunately, they listened, and the fries will continue to be eaten by the world. Be sure to run, not walk, to the Murray Taco Bell to grab yourself some nacho fries with your meal before supplies run out.
That's all for Hot Topics. When we come back, we'll have Zach Claggett on for an interview about Big Beef cinematography. Stay tuned.
Welcome back to MSU Tonight. I'm joined here by Zach Claggett, who has apparently made his own cinematography company, which, if you ask me, is like no big deal because I have like 1,000 of them. But regardless, how are you today, Zach?
I'm doing pretty good. Living life.
Oh, yeah, I care. So why the name Big Beef? Did you just have like a really good burger one day or something?
No, actually, one of my friends, when I first got a PC, made fun of my computer mouse that I had. It was too big. Mm-hmm. And he called it Big Beef, and then later on that day, I was sleeping in their in his bed, just taking a nap, and I was taking over the entire bed, and he got on me. He was like, move over, Big Beef, and it has stuck ever since.
That is just so quirky. So yeah. What projects have you made so far? I'm going to watch them anyway, but...
I can literally hear you.
Sorry, go ahead. What projects have you made so far?
Well, I've made a good handful of projects starting back from my senior year in high school when I made a film called Janitor's Closet. Don't watch it. It was bad. But I've progressed into making a film called Unaware Affection. You could watch it, but I don't prefer it. And then after that, I believe it was my second semester of freshman year, during Film Fest and TV Club, we made a film called Cypher FM. I guess that was my first really good film. And then later on into spring semester of 2022, I made a film called Grief.
Excellent. So, yeah, so what's coming up in Big Beef Cinematography's future? Perhaps bankruptcy?
No. I don't know why you would think that. I'm going to make money, hopefully, one day. Probably not. But anyways, we plan on, hopefully, in the spring semester of 2023, make a actual feature-length film called Collide. I can't tell you too much about it, but got a lot of high hopes for it.
really great to hear. But you know, where can I find this content, this Big Beef Cinematography masterpieces, so I can avoid them?
I can literally still hear you. I don't know where that's coming.
Sorry,
from.
Go on.
You
know with the question.
Okay. All right. So you can find them at youtube.com/bigbeef, BIGBEEF. You can see it here, Big Beef. It's probably hardly visible, but it's there. And yeah, you can just see all those and some of my older videos on there if you'd like to watch those as well.
You know, since you're so awesome and successful, could you just give any advice for any future cinematographers out there?
Do your best, as you know, just work as much as you can, do as much projects as you can to put it against your portfolio to show a lot of people. That's the best advice I can probably give.
You know, dear viewers, any advice I can give you is to just not listen to this guy.
I can literally still, bro, why would you, you know what, bro, this was dumb, this was so stupid, give me a second, I'm out.
And since I know how to work these properly, because I am a cinematographer, I'm going to leave it right here, and I'm done. This is bullshit!
Well, that was Big Bitch Cinematography. Here's a clip from Big Beef Cinematography's Grief. When we come back, I'm going to be enjoying some hot sauce covered McNuggets while reviewing the short film you just watched, Grief. Stay tuned. Welcome back. I have before me many chicken McNuggets covered in some Melinda's Ghost Pepper Sauce. Now look at those. Now, before you ask, why chicken McNuggets? I don't like bone-in wings, and I am not afraid to admit that. I mean, people like to say boneless wings are, you know, they're chicken nuggets. Who cares? They taste better. But nonetheless, I will not only be enjoying these delicious spicy McNuggets, but I will also be reviewing the hit short film Grief, created by Big Beef Cinematography. So, without further ado, let me get into these nuggets. So, I'm just going to eat a couple here before we really get started. They're nice and soggy, how I like them. Mmm. Those are really spicy. So, before I officially begin, I must warn you guys for spoilers ahead of Grief. Go watch it on YouTube if you haven't. If you have, stay and watch this review. So, Grief is a short film detailing the day-to-day life of a college student named Jason. However, Jason is changed when he meets and begins dating Elizabeth. Sorry, I'm really hungry. I need to get another one. Their relationship is going great. Until one day, Elizabeth gets in a tragic car accident, leaving Jason with nothing but his grief. Get it? Jason continues through the stages of grief until he finally accepts Elizabeth's death while making some nice friends along the way. Ooh, okay. We're going back in. Okay, Grief does an excellent job of highlighting the ups and downs that are associated with love and loss. Anything that the film lacks through budget is made up through the film's incredible amount of heart. Alec Wadley is phenomenal as Jason and really shows pain in his performance. The cinematography done by Big Beef Cinematography portrays the elements of grief so well, especially for a topic such as death, that is oftentimes not a good sight. Overall, I give Big Grief by Big Beef. I give Grief an astounding 4.5 Dead Girlfriends out of 5. If you want to check out Grief, just search Big Beef on YouTube. Stick around after the break to see your host eat these nuggets and to hear the thrilling conclusion of this MSU Tonight episode. Stay tuned.
Thanks for watching today's wild episode of MSU Tonight. Be sure to come back next Tuesday for more.
I guess we're gonna eat one of these wings real quick. Jesus, they're so soggy.
Let's see how hot they are. I mean, it packs a punch. What do you think?
Jesus, that's horrible. Find us on YouTube at youtube.com/MSU Tonight. Thanks for tuning in for the show.
Bye, everyone. So fun.
It's really spicy. That's all I got. There's 3 left. Dude, I'm about to vomit because they're so soggy.
Are they really?
Yeah.
It's really hot.
Oh my god.